Chelsy Davy made clear her absolute desire to stay out of the public eye while dating Prince Harry before their relationship broke down. Harry and Meghan Markle continue to bask in the media spotlight despite having left the UK for private lives. While the pair spent 2020 locked down in their multi-million dollar home, this year has seen them appear in a string of interviews. The biggest and most controversial event happened in March when the pair sat down with US talk show host and close friend Oprah Winfrey. Here, Meghan divulged the pain and suffering she endured while part of the royal family. Accusing the firm of failing to help her struggles with mental health, before Meghan, Harry had two serious relationships, first with Chelsy Davy, later Cressida Bonas. Many royal watchers believed that Chelsy was destined to become the next official member of the royal family. She and Harry dated on and off for 7 years after meeting as teenagers. Her reasons for dumping Harry appear to resonate with many of the claims made by Meghan. Namely, the intensity of public attention while dating a senior royal. Julie Montagu, a royal commentator, claimed that Chelsy made her opposition to becoming a fixture of public discourse clear from the outset. Speaking to Channel 5 documentary, Charles and Harry, Father and Son Divided. She said, Chelsy was like, absolutely not. I don't want to be in the public eye. I don't want to be written about in papers. It was the same thing with Cressida. We know that both of those girls ended that relationship because they did not want this life in the public eye by being married to a senior member of the royal family. Years later, Chelsy would reveal her feelings and the reason behind why she dumped Harry. Speaking to The Times in 2016, she said, "It was so full on, crazy and scary and uncomfortable. I found it very difficult when it was bad. I couldn't cope, I was trying to be a normal kid and it was horrible." Despite this, the two remain on good terms. Chelsy attended Harry's 2018 wedding to Meghan. Cressida was also invited to the ceremony. The actress has similarly spoken out since her split with Harry in 2014. In an interview with Australia's Daily Telegraph last year, she confessed fears of becoming an it girl because of her stint with Harry. She said, "The fear of failing, the fear of rejection, the fear of not getting it right, the fear of not being perfect. I think that has limited me in certain situations in my life." The publication said it hinted at what could have been had she married into the firm. In her 2017 biography, Harry, Life, Loss and Love, royal author Katie Nicol wrote of how Cressida had been totally spooked after watching Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, fulfilling royal duties on tour. Ms. Nicol wrote, "Cressida had been completely spooked while watching TV coverage of William, Kate and George touring New Zealand and Australia that spring." A friend told the author, she, Cressida, was sitting at home watching Kate on the royal tour of Australia, and it was a wake-up call. There was no way she wanted that sort of attention and she told Harry so. The friend also revealed, Harry didn't want things to end. He was in love with her and he tried to convince her they could make it work, but Cressida's mind was made up. Harry suffered a real blow when she said, "I can't do this." I think she really broke his heart. Ms. Nicol added, "Twice, Harry had been left heartbroken because the women he had fallen in love with didn't want to share the life he had been born into."